If you want to know how to streamline and improve your lead qualification process using VideoAsk, you're in the right place. Hey, I'm Susie. I am the video educator at VideoAsk, and today I'm going to walk you through a lead qualification VideoAsk step by step so that you can include one just like it in your inbound marketing funnel. I'll show you exactly the types of videos that you can make and the different paths that you can set up in VideoAsk to help you qualify your leads as hot, warm, and cold. But first, let's recap real quick what lead qualification is. So lead qualification is normally part of your inbound marketing strategy. And any good inbound marketing strategy has three key areas of focus. The first is generating demand and attracting an audience, normally by creating content to help your audience find you. So this can be anything from blog posts to white papers to video content. The second is once people have landed on your website. So you want to keep these people engaged and capture them as leads. And ideally at this stage, you want to capture your most promising leads so that you can turn them into customers. Which brings us to the third focus area, which is delighting your customers. So once your leads have converted, you want to make sure that you give them the best customer experience possible. So we want to focus on step two here, which is where lead qualification happens. So normally that can happen through something like a form on your landing page, like maybe a type form, or some gated content like ebooks or white papers where people have to give their email address in order to access that content. But sometimes you might want something different or you want something a little bit more. So high touch businesses like real estate or consulting, they need to build trust really quickly with their audience, which is where VideoAsk can really come in handy. Showing someone behind the brand on camera can help build trust and help both capture and qualify leads at the same time. And that is exactly what our lead qualification VideoAsk will do. So without further ado, let's walk through how to structure the flow of your VideoAsk so that you can engage and qualify leads coming to your website. And if you stick around to the very end, we'll give you a tip on how to get started with this exact same flow so that you can make your very own lead qualification VideoAsk. Let's go. Okay, so here we are in the VideoAsk Builder where you can create your video funnel. So here we have a lead qualification VideoAsk already set up, and I'm going to walk you through each step to see how it works to qualify your leads. So what we see here is a map of our steps with the logic already set up. So even though we have six steps in total, so you can see here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. Not everyone will see each step because we've set rules for that, as you can see with the way that it flows and connects. But you're really going to get all the information you need to qualify your leads with this VideoAsk. So let's get started. I'm going to click on step one here, and I'm going to play this video for you so you can see what it's all about.
Hi there. We offer one-on-one mentoring consultancy services for first-time business owners. If you're selected, we'll match you with one of our industry experts to help you with everything from applying to grants and loans, filing your taxes, and making sense of EBITDA, P&L, and all the other fun acronyms. To make sure our services are going to be a good fit, I'm going to ask you a few questions. First, how old is your company?
So this is a mentoring and consulting service for small businesses or first-time business owners, and they specialize in growing very small businesses. So the first question asking how old the company is, it's really just a screening question to help us weed out more established companies from the new startups. So if we click on the logic tab here, we can see that the first two options, A and B, take us to step two, and then option C takes us to step six. So let's go back here to step one, and let's try clicking on one of these two options. So if we say A, less than a year, we're taken to step two. So let's see what this is all about.
How many people currently work at your company, including yourself?
Basically, in that first step, we've already started qualifying our leads. We want small businesses. So this is an additional step to help us qualify our leads, asking about the company size. So again, if we click on the logic here, we'll see that A and B will jump to step three. and C&D will jump to step 4. Now, if we go back into step 2 here, we'll see that A and B are the smaller companies, so anything fewer than 5 people, and C&D are 6 and up. So here our hotter leads would be ones that are 5 people or less. If we click on one of these options, we are taken to the next step for our hot leads. Let's see what this video says.
Great. Sounds like you'd really benefit from what our program has to offer. Please give a short introduction to yourself and your business, and we'll get back to you as soon as possible with more application details.
So now we've got a highly qualified lead. This company fits our criteria and we want to work with them. Here we're asking for a bit more information to help give us a better idea of what the project might look like. And here we give them the option to respond via video, audio, or text so that they can really get into all the nitty-gritty details of their business. If we close this here, we'll see that this path leads to the end screen. That means that this lead has been officially qualified as a hot lead. But as you can see here, we have a little contact form icon. That means that we'll collect their contact details so we can get back in touch. This is the contact form. And you can choose at which step you want to collect these details. So if you click on any step, here you can see this is toggled on. Every step will have this option so that you can choose which step it makes sense for you to collect contact details. Here we can see that they've gone down the highly qualified path, so we definitely want to collect their contact details. Okay, so that is the first path done. So this is the path for our hottest leads who fit our criteria and are ready for our services. Okay, now let's go back to step 2. And we're going to go down this path of either choosing C or D, which wouldn't be our most qualified lead, but still somebody that we could potentially do business with. So let's choose option C, and both C and D will take us to this step, which is step 4. Let's play the video.
Great. Congratulations on such a fast pace of growth. Unfortunately, our current program is best suited to smaller teams. However, next year, we'll be expanding to offer mentoring and consultancy services for larger and more complex teams. Would you like to be added to the waiting list for this program?
Okay, so here, basically, they don't qualify for our program, but we obviously don't want to totally discard them just yet. We have plans to expand our services in the near future, and we want to give them the opportunity to join our waiting list so that they can be a part of our future endeavors. So this is still a pretty good lead because we know that they're interested in our services, and even though we can't accommodate them just yet, we still want to keep them as a contact for when we do have the resources available to provide our services. So once more on this step, let's try selecting yes. This is if the lead is interested in joining the waitlist. Okay, and let's play this video.
Wonderful. And ideally, what would you like to see in a mentoring program like this?
Okay, so this step is actually super useful because here we give them the chance to give some input into what they're looking for from the program. This is kind of a win-win step because they're telling us exactly what they need. And since our mentoring program for larger teams isn't exactly fully fleshed out yet, we can get insight into what a company of this size is looking for and ultimately provide a better service. So this is a really good step just to get some additional feedback from your leads. And again, if we exit here, once they finish this step, as you can see, they'll be asked for their contact details. The contact form is here, and then they'll be taken to the end screen. So this is the path for our warmer leads. They're not quite perfect for our services, but they could definitely be customers in the near future. So we're obviously keeping them kind of warm, so to speak. Okay, and now let's go back to step 4. If they decide they don't want to be on the waiting list, so if they were to say no here, they'll be taken directly to the end screen. Here we're not asking them for contact info because we know that they're not totally interested. We don't want to push, and we're just not going to bother them by asking them for their contact information at this point. Okay, finally, we're going to go all the way back to step 1. And this would be for our colder leads. and we're going to choose the option for 2 to 5 years. This is the path that we haven't taken yet. Okay, let's play this video.
Thanks so much for your interest and congrats on growing your business this far. We're looking for early stage entrepreneurs, so this won't be the right program for you, unfortunately. However, would you like to learn more about our mentoring and consultancy services for advanced entrepreneurs?
So anyone that answered C isn't really a good fit for this specific program. But again, even though they are cold leads, we don't want to leave them out in the cold either. So we're going to offer them the option to get some more information about a similar program that might be right for them. Here, if we select yes, they are going to be redirected to a web page with more information about that specific program. So here we just have a placeholder link, but in a real world scenario, we would be redirecting them to a page on our site that can give them more information about this program. And if we exit here and select no, then again, they'll be taken to the end screen. So we're not asking them for any contact info and we're not sending them anywhere else. They are just not a fit for us. And that's okay. That's the whole point of lead qualification. It's to find leads that are most suited to your business. So this is the path for our colder leads. And that is it. That is the entirety of our lead qualification video ask. So we went through each step and how each answer leads down different paths so that you can qualify your leads as hot, warm, and cold. So as I promised, if you want to get started with this very same video ask, we actually have this video ask as a template in the product so that you can get started, swap out the videos, change up the answers, and create your very own video ask using this very same setup. So if you want to try VideoAsk, if you want to try creating a lead qualification form, if you want to get more leads, you can sign up with VideoAsk in the link in the description below. And of course, if you like this video, don't forget to like and subscribe for more content just like this. Or if there's something that you want to see on this channel, please let us know. We'll see you in the next video.